What's going on? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Isaac Leffler. Thank you for joining us. Today we'll be listening to Heard It in a Past Life by Maggie Rogers. I'm attempting to break outside of my box a little bit. This is an artist I have pretty much nothing about. I know Pharrell kind of co-signed her in a video a long time ago, but besides that, really have no background on anything she's ever done. I do know my brother and his girlfriend like her a lot. I've had a couple other people recommend her music as well. So without further ado, let's get into track one. Give a Little. Here we go. Not really what I was expecting. Interesting sound. Okay. So look at me and hear me now with all the place. Heavy drums. Where no one knows me. Oh, okay. No one knows your weapons, jump your gun. A little bit of a love song, okay. Not minding it. I like that in the background, that a synth. Ooh, okay. This feels like a better version of like the pop music I used to like when I was a kid. Sounds like a summer day, top down on a convertible kind of song, too. Ooh, I like that right there. Sounds like she's one of them, like, give ground in a relationship. Maybe just with people in general. Like, you learn that you don't have to always agree. You can just give a little. You can love each other more. So that's like everybody in general. Pretty solid. Starting to hit the outro a little bit. Solid though so far. Interesting. Very, very interesting. Nice outro. Nice little vocal performance there as well. Yeah, okay, let's talk about Give a Little. I think my analysis throughout was pretty accurate, but it could be about a relationship, could be about people in general, just like realizing you don't always have to agree about everything. You can agree to disagree, you can give a little bit of ground, and you could still, you know, be cordial, be friendly, don't have to agree on every little thing that like everybody else has an opinion about. Just like, you know, just a good message. Did enjoy it. Solid. Really didn't know what to expect. Like I said, also during the song, kind of felt like the pop version of songs I used to like when I was younger. Similar kind of vibe there. So I wonder if that'll carry out through the rest of the album. Go to the next one, Overnight. Here we go. I remember way back, claimed it. She lost it. I lost it. Saying you would come back, run back, find me in the front porch like again. That, but you waited overnight. Not as much energy as the last song, but not bad. I'm gonna hear it out. I'll still meet you in the middle of the night, but if you lie to me, lie to me. Don't lie to her. Whiskey and then leave quickly. Whiskey sipper. Like an old man, like a dad. I don't know. The chorus isn't fully hitting for me like the last one did. That in the background's crazy though. I'm about to read the about section too on this one just because I feel they don't have one on Genius. Fuck. Let me know in the comments. People change. I mean. Fake people. Yeah, I don't know. It's definitely not bad, but I just don't know if it's something I would add to my library. In the context so far, it feels like it fits. Cohesion is definitely there. Overnight, like I said, definitely not a bad track. Just something I'm not sure I would add to my library personally. It's just, I don't know. It wasn't, it didn't hit for me just like Give a Little did. Give a Little, I enjoyed a lot. Solid opening to the album. Fits in the context of the two songs I've heard so far. Maybe I'll feel differently about it after the rest of the album's done. Didn't fully connect for me. I think she was talking about fake people changing. It's like you're one way one day and then the next day you're a different person all in general. Same time about like fake people, I guess. So it's just like things change overnight. If you lie to me, lie to me. That kind of thing. That's what I was getting from it at least. So yeah, let's go to the next one though. The Knife. Here we go. It's weighing me. Okay. Like the vocal performance here so far. Okay. And maybe go if you won't get loud. Make a little fuss so it's all allowed. You I'm liking this performance so far. Okay. I don't know how to describe this. This beat. I enjoy it though. Whoa, to me. I like this one better. This is a better snap back into me than Overnight was. Ooh, I like that in the background there. Ooh, that build was crazy. Okay, I'll fuck with this one. I don't know why, I just thought of that TikTok where it's like white girl dancing like to this song. I don't know why, it just made me chuckle. Let me know if you know what that means in the comments. I'm fucking with this one. It's my favorite one so far. I'm looking at Spotify. This one doesn't have as many listens either. This one's, I'm fucked with this one. Okay. That was some good shit right there, man. That was some good shit. I don't know. Just like the whole package there of the song, I was really loving it. I am going to read this unreviewed about section for this song. And it is saying, this song seems to be describing an important insight that Maggie has had about life. To me, it seems she's figured out that it's all about caring for each other. She's in the song saying, hit me up if you're feeling down. Give a little and we'll forgive this out. Keep me up. Keep my mind turned around after dark, after light. She's being there for the people, loving them. Yeah, okay. Nice message. Good song. Really enjoy the whole thing. So the next one, Alaska. Here we go. Bit of a switch up from the other ones. I was walking through icy streams that over glacial plains. Vocal performance is good again here. Whoa. Okay, I think that's what I'm liking the most is the vocal performances from her. She's delivering. Okay. Okay, I thought the beat drop was gonna be a little good. Or not a little good, a little heavier. Might be because I'm like expecting like rap like I've been listening to a lot, but still enjoying this. Vocal performance is great again. It's like there's a few artists that have like that distinction, say the Kid Kitty hums. She's got like that thing, I don't know. I don't know how to describe it. Okay. So it seems, okay. See, I'm fucking with this. I'm fucking with this. It's got a little bit of a dance vibe to it. But, like, the vocals aren't necessarily, like, the most dance. But, like, everything else in the song is kind of, like, leading that direction. With the drums and everything. Okay, building more. We are finishing out the track. Alaska, solid track, man. Really did enjoy it. The vocal performance was great. Had that nice kind of like dance style drums, but like the song lyrics and like the vocal performance didn't necessarily match that vibe, but like, I don't know. It all worked together somehow. I'm going to read the about section on Genius. Okay, this is the song that Pharrell co-signed her from. Following this viral video of her session with Pharrell Williams, Masterclass in New York, blah, blah, blah. Alaska is a beautiful balance between folk and dance. Okay, yeah. I could definitely see that. The folk, I don't know much about folk, so maybe that's why I couldn't draw a comparison there. But yeah, solid stuff there from Miss Rogers. Let's go to the next one. Light On. Here we go. Would you believe me now if I told you I got caught up in a way? Crying in the bathroom, had to figure it out.
She's crying in the bathroom. Oh, no. No.
I don't know about this one. This one's kind of drawn me back to Overnight, where it's like, I don't know. Kind of has... Nah, never mind. Leave the light on for... Oh, no. I like that right there. Do you believe me now that I always had the best intent many ways? She's vulnerable in so many ways.
Everybody's telling her how to feel. Okay, where's she going with this?
Oh no, for some reason this one like reminds me of like church music. Like the delivery of the lyrics. Not like her voice, but like I want to say flow because, like, I'm thinking rap, but, like, the way she's, like, I don't know. That's the best way I could describe it. She leave the light on. I just saw that this one has a lot of streams on it, so I feel like they're going to be hating on me in the comments, but I don't know. That's just how I feel. This one, I don't know if it's fully for me. I'll read the about section. Maybe it'll clear up things for me, or make add some sort of more meaning, I guess. I'm just gonna read the about section on Genius for that one because I gave you guys my opinion pretty much already. As the last song written for Rogers heard in a past life, so this is the last one she wrote. Maybe it would be better if it was the last song on the album. Just a thought. I'm not the one who wrote the album though, so I'm not gonna say that's just how it should be. She addresses the overwhelming transformation from private to public figure that comes with going viral. Following her sudden fame, Maggie details emotions or feelings ready to break, but ultimately finding the strength in her fans and her music, allowing her to leave the light on for them if they leave the light on for her. Okay, interesting. Again, I just don't know if that one's fully for me. Maybe it's because I'm not like a super big Maggie Rogers fan. Like, I literally just figured out who she was. So that could be definitely part of it. So I can't just connect with it like most of her fans can. But yeah, anyway, let's go to the next one. Past Life. Here we go.
Change coming,
just got the chills.
So it's staring right on.
Bit more somber, but maybe it's like, let's switch it up. Oh no, swing it up.
Masquerading like you were.
Again, the chills. Masquerading. Somebody taking advantage of her? Pianos, I think, was making me like have the chill effect. It's building a little more. Yeah, it's that piano that's doing it for me.
Ooh,
got the chills again, bro. That's like the third time this song. Whoa. So I think she's kind of reflecting on her life again. That's the line that made me think about kind of right ahead in the, on the
maybe
lyrics here.
The best life coming out inside me.
Whoa. Past Life. Really enjoyed that one. I think it's kind of similar to Leave the Light On. Or Light On, where she's kind of just reflecting on her life right now, how it's changing so much. She's saying maybe this is how everything has turned out, how it's supposed to be. Maybe this is like a past life coming out inside of me. I don't know what really she means by the past life coming outside of her. Let me know in the comments if you can clarify that for me. But overall, pretty solid track. Did enjoy it. Let's go to the next one. Say It. Here we go.
Interesting
little techno bit going on between my ears right now. Whoa. Okay, whoa. Crazy dropping. Okay. A little bit of a kind of drops back into a slower, okay. Definitely a love song. Cannot fall in love with you. Just talking earlier in the song about the fingers touch, be too much, relationship kind of thing going on here. I like this one. Another one of those songs like where it's ending, I feel like, again, I said earlier in the track, that's one of those songs where you're like summer, night riding. Not running. Sunset, top down. The lyrics might not match that, but the energy of the song. That's what I'm saying. So definitely a love song. Sounds like she's having a little bit of an interest in somebody, but she's saying she cannot fall in love with them. Early in the song, she's talking about like fingertips touching, energy, that kind of thing. So definitely getting that vibe from the song. Did enjoy it. Love that build in and that crazy drop into the like the high crescendo part of the song. That was fantastic. I mean, her vocal performance throughout has been pretty solid to me. And yeah, really am enjoying this so far. Say it. Good stuff. So the next one, On Plus Off, here we go. Interesting. Ooh, that first hit was, like that ping. Whoa. Another harsh dropping on this one. I like that. Ooh, that. Ooh. I like that right there. Okay. Ooh. Another relationship one as well. There's so much going on in this song. I'm like kind of overwhelmed right now. That's like the main thing I'm picking out right now, but like that right there is great. Take me to that place. Solid stuff there. Was a lot going on in that track. I don't feel like I could give a spectacular analysis, so that one's going to be another read of the About section on Genius. On and Off is the third single of Maggie Rogers' debut album. It's about a back-and-forth relationship, but always feels better when they're back together. This song debuted on BBC Live Radio. There's a Twitter link here as well. What is that saying? It's just Maggie Rogers posting, "Thrilled to announce my new song, On and Off, hottest record on BBC R1. Here tonight, 7 p.m. Let me know in the comments. Give me some more analysis on that one. I don't know. There's a lot going on there. But yeah, let's go to the next one. Falling Water. Here we go. This is a very different from anything she's done so far. At least in the intro. Okay. Getting harder. This one kind of feels like, I think it was, what was the one I said sounded like church music? This was like, I get that same feeling again. Oh man. Yeah, I can't not hear it now, like whenever I hear it. Getting darker. I don't know, you know, I gotta get my peace. I don't know why I'm yawning. Probably because I'd work, but. The song is not about to end, even though it just did feel like it was, the way it was outroing. At least it felt like it was. How many times am I going to say it felt like it was? Still 2 minutes left. It's like a more prolonged outro, is that what this is? I don't know, man. I don't know. I feel like there she didn't let her she had good like a good vocal performance, but like the other ones I feel like she was trying to be more outside the box, where this one felt a little bit more traditional. Read the About section says the motif of water runs throughout the song as an earthly metaphor for Maggie's emotion. But the song structure also mirrors the flow of water. It starts gradually, slow, and restrained as she pinpoints the moment where she started losing control in a doomed relationship. I don't know. That one just didn't fully hit for me. Let's go to the next one. Retrograde. Here we go. This beat's very different from what she's been doing the rest of the album so far, so I'm not sure how I feel about it. I don't know, this one kind of a similar feeling. That's just not fully hitting for me. Like, I feel like she's not being outside the box she was on the songs that I've really liked so far. The beat's different, but like, I don't know. I don't know. This one, again, just not really doing it for me. I don't know about this one. I'll give her points for trying to be outside the box of the beat. Yeah, Retrograde, I don't really know about that one. It just didn't really connect for me. The beat was outside the box, but the vocal performance really don't feel like it matched all that well to what the beat was going on with. Here's what the About section on Genius has to say. Maggie on Instagram had this to say. This song is about a breakdown. It is the most amazing feeling to play this one live. To yell with every part of me and feel the air from the back of my throat. Retrograde motion is when an object's motion is in the opposite of another object's spaceship. Burn, retrograde to exit orbit and fall back to the ground. Maggie is breaking down in the wrong direction and will crash if it keeps going like this. Let's go to the next one. Burning. Here we go. This one kind of feels like, Alaska a little bit. Found another, called him a lover. Somebody helping her feel like herself again. They've started to feel more poppy also the last four songs. The last three songs. Like, Falling Water, Retrograde, this one, are feeling more pop. Or the other ones, like, I feel like she had her own thing going. Like that, like, da-da-da. Don't know if I'm loving the cowbells in the background either. Yeah, again, this one feels very much like a pop song, to me at least. It's the key really bad right now. Yeah, I don't know about this one. Feels like more of a radio song to me, personally. That one, again, really just didn't do it for me. It felt more like a pop song. Me, not the biggest pop guy. The other ones felt a little bit more unique. Maybe like they said in the other About section, more like folk pop. That one, I don't know, just like I said. Didn't really hit for me. So the last track of the album, Back in My Body. Here we go. I'm assuming she's starting to feel like herself again. Because a lot of this is talking about like her dealing with fame. So maybe she's finally back to normal. Back to stopped in London when kind of getting back to that other feeling that she had earlier in the album. This is a bit better for me. This is a good closeout to the album. Good outro song. Neck cracked a million different ways. Building. Not a whole lot of commentary right now. I'm just kind of trying to think of like what I'm going to. I'm trying to gather my thoughts on the entire album as a whole because I do feel like there's a good encapsulation at the end. It's like we've been on a journey with her. Like this is it's like kind of being resolved, I guess. It's like we've been on the road with her, and like now it's kind of like the ending resolve. So she's back in her body. Okay, Back in My Body. I do feel like that was a good way of ending the album. do appreciate how she managed to do that. And this album did actually have a full theme, which I do appreciate. A lot of the albums we've been listening to recently are just kind of like scattered all over the place, being those like producer albums or whatever. But this one had a theme, and it's about her dealing with that viral sensation, like blowing up kind of factor, where you're like, okay, maybe not a lot of people have experienced this. She's able to put it in song and in a nice way for a good amount of the tracks, like The Knife, Alaska, Past Life, Say It, On and Off. Those highlights of the album for me. The last four songs kind of felt like a bit more pop. Back in My Body was a good way to bring it back down. I felt like she was doing in the middle and the beginning of the album. But yeah, overall, did enjoy the album. Glad that I gave Maggie Rogers a chance and branched outside my box a little bit. But if I'm thinking about giving this album as a whole a ranking, I think I'm going to give it a 72%. I know a lot of you would be like, you just said you liked it so much. How are you going to give it a 72%? If I count the amount of tracks I liked, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7-ish, 8-ish, 8 out of 12, 7, 8 out of 12, around 70%. So that's what it's going to be. 72% is how I'm feeling. And I hope you guys enjoyed listening to this album with me, because I enjoyed listening to this album. And I appreciate you guys watching the video. I would greatly appreciate it if you liked and subscribed to the channel. That would be amazing. If you'd like to see the full uncut, uncensored version of this reaction, click the link down below to my Patreon and see all of my uncut reactions on there that I've ever done on the channel. Follow my all my other social link down there below as well. And yeah, with all that being said, thank you guys for listening and watching. I'll see you next time. Peace out. Stay safe out there, guys.